Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, I'm going to drag something into plain view that has been hidden during the last few weeks. I have made this video about an effect and the video has been unlisted, but it had a lot of views. So let's give it some explanation and drag it into plain sight. It's about this design, and this is something that is editable in Illustrator, so several aspects of it are editable. It's not a placed Photoshop file, and there are several aspects of it that maybe need some explanation. So we have this shape, and it has kind of a soft edge, and some aspects of it are even softer, where it looks like there are light leaks. And it also has this kind of bitmap structure applied. So you see those are sharp edged bitmaps. If you have been quite a long time Apple user, then you know this from the 90s when Apple had this kind of look on their packaging. And of course, it's easy to create in Photoshop, where you can just turn your artwork into bitmap, so that is one bit color depth. But how do we do that in Illustrator? So let's start with that base shape. And for that, I'm going to draw an ellipse like this. And let's make this black. And also, we need some slightly smaller ellipses, like here, and another one here. And these, I'm going to really glue them together, so let's just apply the Pathfinder to them like this. Let's not create a compound shape, because we are now applying a freeform gradient, and freeform gradients are not that editable, but still they are editable. So let's go to the gradient tool and turn on that freeform gradient, and Illustrator puts a gradient into it. So I'm going to undo that. Let's first go into the preferences and turn off that. So I'm going to disable the content aware defaults. And when I then click, then nothing happens. Illustrator doesn't put any useless gradient stops inside of that. So we can just start with creating our own gradient. And we need to draw a line. And then let's just put one here. And that one needs to be white, like this. And then we just make that on the outside. And it needs to be white there. And then we are going inside of here, and you see Illustrator shapes that line completely on its own. We do not need to move any handles or the like. And we just go here and keep that kind of close to that edge. In there, we do not need to stay that close to the border, because we want to keep that kind of leaking over there. So like this, and maybe keep them slightly different. So whatever you want that to be. Now we need another line. So let's start that, but going to make it black, of course. And then around the edge here, we need to have them stay close together, and in here, not so close. You need to be careful. These lines must not cross. That's not allowed. So just make them close together, but not cross. Like this. So let's close it here. And let's take a look at that. That's okay for the design. So that's just it. Leaking lights. You can, of course, adjust that by just taking that gradient tool again and move these around. So just to shape that leak different. And that's that. So we can do it like this and move this closer to the outside and make it look more like a circle here. Just like that. And that's it. Inside of that, you can make another one, which is maybe a dark gray. So let's just make a dark gray, which might make that more interesting or maybe not. We can just try out what will happen. That's maybe a little too light already. So let's get this darker and double click it to get it darker, just like so. And again, just one step darker, like this. Okay. So now comes the bitmap one bit effect. So we're going to use the appearance panel and then first of all we're going to apply the rasterize effect, and this is an RGB document as you see here, but we need that to be grayscale, so not the document, that's not possible, just this object, so we can turn that to grayscale. We can also select a different resolution in here. So let's just do that and have that a different resolution of maybe 30 ppi. And I'm going to keep that white. That is also important. So like this. And then you already see it's looking differently. So the next thing is we need an effect that creates those dots. So let's go to the effect gallery. And we need the graphic pen. So like this graphic pen, which makes these lines. And these lines normally have a stroke length that is longer. And then, of course, you get those lines. But if we make that one, then we get just dots. So you can zoom in here. You see, there are just dots now. But this is still not black and white. There are some grayscales in that. So this is slightly blurred. You can experiment with this setting here, but it doesn't. Yes, it does change a lot if you move it to the left, but to the right, not a lot happens. Just like this. Okay. So now we have this, but we want that sharp bitmap look. And to get that, we're going to effect and apply another rasterize effect to this. And since we already have one, so let's just apply the next one. And this time turning that into bitmap and transparent. So let's go to OK. And you see now it has these sharp corners just as we wanted this to be. And maybe you see, OK, this is too light in the center. So let's just go to the gradient tool and then you can edit this and move them closer together or delete them all together or add another ring to that here and making that black, whatever you want, just like so. But now we also want to have that in color in order to put some shading somewhere. And to get that, we now need a group. So let's go to Object Group. And to that group, we need to apply a new fill. And that fill can have a color. And then we have this in a color. And still, we could go in and change those gradients. And maybe this needs to be rounder. Or like here, it needs to be edited, whatever you like, you can still do it and adjust that to where you want to use it.